JD Vance has previously called Donald Trump an idiot and America's Hitler. Now his vice presidential pick and embraced by Republican power brokers. Vance has been quick to articulate accord with his running mate on foreign policy, from Gaza to Iran and...
Russia would not have invaded Ukraine if Donald Trump had been president.
The first-term senator is one of the loudest opponents of aid to Ukraine, determined to reorient resources away from Europe.
Negotiate with the Russians and Ukrainians, bring this thing to a rapid close so that America can focus on the real issue, which is China. That's the biggest threat for our country, and we're completely distracted from it.
Beijing loathe to be included in electioneering. There are concerns in Europe, most notably from German coalition partners, who say a Trump-Vance White House would hand Ukraine to Russia.
He wants to bring manufacturing and jobs back into the US Rust Belt. He's been quite a supporter of US industrial policy. However, we have also seen him demonstrate brief, but still there, support for AUKUS in his speech at the Munich Security Conference earlier this year.
Vance's previous assertion he doesn't care what happens to Ukraine is a world away from the current US position.
Russia continues to erode confidence in our institutions while willfully and flagrantly violating the core tenets of the United Nations Charter.
Russia warning the UN-centric system is being put to the test. And while not endorsing a change in leadership, called the Biden administration's analysis of global conflicts delusional.
Today, the countries of the collective West are clearly overrepresented.
As president, Trump said the UN and NATO wasted US resources. Analysts say JD Vance could push a second Trump term into greater isolationism.
We have seen vice presidents in the past take a more prominent and influential advisory capacity to the president. So we did see this with Mike Pence, Donald Trump's first vice president. So even though we are very likely to see Trump lead a Trump administration policy agenda, that's not to say that we won't see someone like JD Vance as a vice president have a more influential role, maybe on foreign policy and potentially more behind the scenes.
A partnership looking to be sealed on November 5th. Liz Maddock, SBS World News.